name's Laura Imbruglia and I'm from the central coast of New South Wales, but I don't live there anymore. I live in Sydney. So you could say I'm from Sydney. Please say I'm from Sydney. The way I came up with the cover for my album is I was reading a book on Frida Kahlo. I just was falling asleep one night and I thought I'd get my friend to do a version of one of Frida's paintings, except have me as Frida. And instead of having spider monkeys, I'd have the Carpenters, Bob Dylan and Freddie Mercury. I don't know why. I was falling asleep. You just come up with weird things when you're falling asleep. I'd love to go to Mexico and see Frida's house, and I just want to go overseas. I've only been overseas once. I just want to go anywhere, everywhere.
Well, I'm in the bedroom of Laura Imbruglia, and you just saw her clip there looking for a rabbit, which has been pretty much cutting sick here on JTV. Lots of votes coming in, jtv.com.au. Laura, thank you for inviting me into your very cool bedroom.
Thanks for coming in.
Now, with your film clip, incredibly colourful, lots of green, and it makes me want to go and have a peppermint tea.
Mm-hmm.
Did you enjoy the process of bringing your song to life in pictures?
I did. It was great, and very little was required of me, which is always good.
What exactly did you have to do?
I just had to be filmed singing the song twice in front of my kitchen door. And then they turned me into a stencil. And, there were two people that worked on the film clip and they just went nuts.
Wowee. So yeah. Did they actually say to you, look, this is the idea that we have for your song?
Mm-hmm.
And they took every lyric literally?
Pretty much, yeah. They asked for the lyrics, they asked me to film, and then they were like, this is our idea. And they went for it, and I just got updates along the way.
Awesome. So that the version that we see is the one version that was ever made. There wasn't another one you went, nah, that's not right.
There was one bit that I got them to change, just one thing.
And what was that?
There was a bit of a Mully Grubbs kind of vibe with the bleeding. There's a bleeding mouth part. They
right.
had an actual mouth instead of a cartoon one. And I was like, Mully Grubbs, don't
yuck,
like it.
Yuck, yuck, yuck.
Yeah.
Well, look, let's talk about your album. It did come out last year, and the self-titled album for Laura. Lyrically, I think it's really quite brilliant and quite eccentric, and I'm a little bit eccentric, so it appealed to me a lot, and
right,
I often like to have a little sing-along and get a little bit angry. You go from anarchist to lettuce to peppermint tea to rabbits. Any lyrics that... Like, when you're writing your lyrics with a particular song, what are you thinking about?
Whatever's on my mind at that particular time. And sometimes I sing gibberish because I'm working on the melody or whatever. And that's why songs like Looking for a Rabbit don't make a lot of sense, because that's a song where I've just left the gibberish and I haven't come back and rewritten, because I just thought, eh, it sounds crazy anyway. So
I like how you take the song, for instance, for like Looking for Rabbits, where you'll just start quite slow and then it'll just pound into this like punky even vibe,
mm-hmm.
and then go back down into a slow tempo. It's really quite schizophrenic. And
yeah.
Is that a hard challenge for you musically, for the arrangements?
So it was kind of hard to record certain parts of it when it gets really fast, because I often write things that I'm not capable of playing really
right.
well.
So you dragged in some musical mates as well. So who did you drag in ask to come in on your album?
I had Nick Kennedy from The Cops and
yeah.
Big Heavy Stuff on drums. I had good friend Stiff on bass. And then I had Dave from Dappled Cities play on a song, and Blackie for the Hard-Ons. And Cool G Murder from the Eels. Well, he's not in the Eels anymore, but he produced one of the songs.
Man, that's pretty cool. So you got to know him pretty well when you were supporting the Eels?
Yeah.
Righto.
Responded, and he was going to do the whole album, but ran out of time. So
when you head out on the road, what happens then musically? You obviously can't bring all them out at once.
Well, I sometimes play with a band and sometimes play solo, and I just kind of mix it up depending on who I'm playing with.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, stick around. Laura Imbruglia is with me. We've got lots more to learn. You're on JTV Saturday. Let's check out the news now at number 11. Horse All Common there on JTV, and I'm still hanging out with Laura Imbruglia, which is kind of dandy for a Saturday morning. Now, let's take you back to your teenage years, and
mm-hmm.
I want you to try and inspire anyone that might have just picked up a guitar.
Okay.
You used to head out and busk.
I did.
Tell me about that.
I used to busk with a friend, Keely. She would have half a drum kit, and I had an acoustic guitar and a mic, and we'd plug into the power. They had like little keys that open it up on the power pole, and we just busk in the marketplace at the entrance on the Central Coast.
That's so impressive, because dragging around a drum kit and then setting it up on a footpath isn't an easy feat in itself.
No, but we really wanted to busk, and I think it was good for building a bit of a thick skin.
Totally, yeah. Because people are just standing there going, oh, what are you doing? What sort of songs were you singing then?
Or just don't stop at all. I was doing a lot of jokey sort of songs in the early days, and I did a few covers as well, but yeah, we just kind of did silly sort of songs.
Did you make enough cash to say it was worth it?
Yeah, we were making like $30 each an hour.
Oh, wow, that's okay.
And charming the pants off the tourists.
Yeah, right.
Yep.
And obviously, I've got to ask you, you're very different to your sister, and musically, you're both probably listening to your parents' music. You went one direction, your sister went in the other. How did that happen? Are you just genetically very different?
Well, yes, but also Mum and Dad didn't really listen to music. They just listened to the Carpenters. So all of us girls, there's four girls, we all like the Carpenters.
Right.
And anything else after that, we had to discover ourselves, because there was just no... We just listened to the radio in the car. That was it. So different tastes, different people, just go in different directions.
And how is it having Daniel Johns as a brother-in-law? Is he good? Does he buy you nice presents?
He buys me good albums for Christmas.
Cool.
Good recommendations.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Now, you're about to go overseas to Berlin for quite the showcase. What's it called?
It's called Popcom, and it's like the Texas Convention South by Southwest, but it's for Europe, so...
In Berlin.
Very exciting.
And you're playing with Hilltop Hoods. Who else?
Architecture in Helsinki, and Becky and the Bullets, and then, yeah, there's a whole lot of international artists as well. It's a big...
So you'll have to be on your best behaviour, because you don't know who's really in the audience.
Yeah, that's true. But I tend to drink when I'm, like, uncomfortable, so, that could be bad.
Well, it's great meeting you today. Good luck. I know you've got quite a few shows next week in Sydney, and I'm with Laura Imbruglia. If you want to check out her album, it is self-titled. And let's check out your request. Why have you gone for Salt and Pepper's Shoop?
I just love it, and I used to watch it all the time when I was in primary school and rap along, and I can still pretty much rap the whole song.
How do you rap word for word?
Well, just word for word.
Okay.
What is it? I was about to do the guys one. I'm not very good with the guys rap, but, you know. Now I can't remember it. Okay. You're packed in your stack, especially in the back, brother. Want to thank your mother for a butt like that. And it's a bit lewd, so I'll stop there. But I could do the whole thing if I wanted to.
Thank you for choosing it today. You're going to inspire a lot. Laura Imbruglia on JTV Saturday. Shoop.
I wanna shoot, baby, shoot.
Ooh, how you doing, baby? Shoot. No, not you. You, the bow-legged one.